Dalgona Challenge. So what's going to happen is we have three flavors that, and we're going to be competing with one another on who can make the best dalgona in the family. And whoever wins will get the sweet trophy. Put it here. So, let's introduce the contestants. Of course, it's just us. Okay, so we're going to introduce the ingredients and our flavors. We have three teams, and we have three flavors. For me and Carlton, we have the matcha milk green tea. This will be our dalgona. We're going to be adding some low fat milk, all purpose cream, and sugar. Okay, so we're moving on to our next segment. So this is Dalgona. We're going to be talking about different subjects and different topics, mainly about parenting, while we're whisking up our ingredients. Instead of using the electric mixer, we're going to use the manual whisk. We're going to whisk it manually because
it's a challenge to.
It's a challenge and
paghihirapan muna natin.
And we're going to be and anyway, magdi-discuss din tayo ng mga topics about parenting and
pero
all that
stuff. Pero pag hindi na namin kaya, pwede kami mag-top up. Pwede pa rin namin gamitin yung mixer. So yun nga, Siege, ako.
It's a perfect time.
In-advest ko na to sinabi sa iyo, Siege, na matagal, parang ano, may relationship na tayo kay ako, ah, kay Lord, meron akong relationship. Pero I don't know, ha, before na kailangan pala uunahin mo si Lord. Before yung pag-handle mo sa kids mo. So you have to consult Jesus. You have to pray for it. Hindi ko alam yun.
So it's much like a covenant wherein the man and the wife have God in their center. But it wasn't always like that for my wife and myself. Before we found God, before we had Him in the center of our relationship, before getting married, our relationship was not just utter chaos, it was hellish. To tell you the truth. Wouldn't you agree?
Super.
So, kailangan kasi ng individual relationship eh. Mm-hmm. So, I needed to establish my own relationship with God. I needed to recognize Him as my Lord and Savior. And she needed to do the same for the triangle to work. Kasi kung isa lang yung nasa triangle, it won't work. Kung isa lang yung nagtatrabaho. So, ganun din ang parenting. I believe that we should also lead them in that direction. Mm-hmm. And might I add, hindi pa rin perfect yung relationship namin. We still have our fair share of arguments. We still fight. We still, you know, disagree on a lot of things. But at least, alam mo, meron ng mediator, you know, we have a divine mediator. Na just to remind us that, hey, you have kids now, hey, it's not about what you want anymore. We can't be selfish anymore.
Anyway, yun nga eh, we're not perfect parents, ha? Kami yung exhibit A, diba?
We're not even a perfect couple.
Yeah. That's why we need to read our devotions and pray to God, quiet time, kasi kailangan natin bumalik sa Kanya kapag nakaka-feel na tayo ng confusion, stress, we need to go back to His Word. So I want to share this verse to you, to all of us, from Proverbs chapter 22, verse 6. It says here, "Train up a child in the way he should go. Even when he is old, he will not depart from it." So, ang dami. Meron, shared natin, CJ, yung 7 na parenting tips from the Bible. Number 1, pray for your children and pray with them. So, sometimes, nafe-feel ko din na ma-stress and magalit, syempre, diba, sa mga anak mo. Na sometimes, you try your best. Minsan nga, nagbabasa pa ako talaga sa mga parenting tips sa Google, gano'n, paano ba dapat? Or minsan, nag-ask din ako sa friends ko, di ba? Na mga moms din. Pero sometimes, it doesn't work. And the best na ako dun sa devotion ko na nabasa, since na-share ko na rin ito sa'yo, di ba? Sometimes, words are not enough. So, go back to His Word. Yun. So, ang ibig sabihin, parang, hindi enough na magalit ka, na gamitin mo yung words mo na stop doing this, no, ganito, oy, bawal yan, masama ka ba? Minsan, hindi enough yun. Sometimes, kailangan mo palang bumalik sa word ni God. And, yun, and pag meron ka ng basis sa word ni Lord, you have to pray for your kids na minsan, out of control na eh. Kahit minsan, 10 times naman ang pinagalitan, tama naman yung way, diba? Minsan, kailangan ng prayer. So, pray for them. And pray with them. Minsan maganda din na pinaparinig mo na how you pray to God with them para naririnig nila kung paano dapat mo mag-pray.
It's like setting an example. Para makita din nila na parang, so this is, they can make it a habit of their own.
Yep. And sometimes kaila, di ba, kunyari, mag-e-exam siya sa school, ganyan. Tapos nag-review kami. And then, nung hinahatid pa kita nito, di ba, remember, nag-review ako, hinahatid. Tapos before you go down, pag-pray muna tayo together na, Lord, I pray na guidance exam, gonna remember that?
Yes.
Yun. So pray for them and pray with them. So number 2, CJ, ikaw, balance love and discipline.
Balance love and discipline. So that's like, think of a skin, not the one you see in your bathroom, the justice scale.
Yes.
It has to be even. So, on one side of the scale is love, on the other side is discipline. If one is more than the other, then that's going to cause damage. And not, what do you mean by damage? If there's too much love with too little discipline, you're going to spoil the child. And he's going to grow up thinking that he's his own God. On the other hand, if you have too much discipline with too little love, he's going to be scarred for life. He's not going to feel love. He's going to feel like he's a mistake in this world, and you wouldn't want your child feeling that. So you need that perfect balance, which is near impossible in our world. So you need God to even things out for you. You know, as much as we try to be the perfect parents that we can be, it's just not going to work if it's just her and me. Just like the scale, if she has the love, I have the discipline, we need that person in the middle. And who is that in the middle of us?
Number 3, go back and remember the times when you were still praying for your child to grace your life. Wow, parang bagay.
Sometimes nakakalimot kasi tayo na blessing sila.
Yeah, to grace your life. Especially when being a parent gets harder and harder. So nice.
Okay,
sobrang nice natin number 3 kasi totoo nga naman no, lalo na sa experience natin si Jay kasi tayo, hindi naman tayo mabilis din, hindi easy for us na makapag-consider nito. Alam mo yung pinaghirapan mo siya, tapos like si Kira experience ko more than a year and si Carlton rainbow baby siya, di ba? Every time nagpa-positive yung test natin, parang naalala mo na, sobrang, wow, thank you, Lord. Pero, normal to, CJ. CJ, Exhibit A tayo dito. Na pag pinanganak na sila, parang feeling mo, ano ba yan? Diba? Nabibili mo yun.
Isipin mo na lang na how lucky and blessed you are to have them in your life. Because back then, you were crying about them. You were crying for them na, Lord, we want this life. We want you to bless us with an offspring. And yung binigay na ni God sa'yo, what a privilege, right? What a privilege. It's just hard to see all that sometimes kung nagtatantrum na sila on a random Tuesday night. It's hard to see that when they've pooped their diaper for the 11th time today.
Anyway, CJ number 4. Sabi dito, children should shine inside, not just outside.
I get that because as a parent, as parents, we want our children to shine outside. But what do you mean by outside? We want to post to the world how much they're growing, how much they're excelling. You know, when they get straight A's, when, you know, they take their first steps, they're shining, you know? And that's all in good. There's nothing wrong with seeing them and pushing them to shine. But we have to wonder how much they're shining also inside of themselves. Because we know that story of that kid, you know, that we all knew when we were growing up, how he or she was shining so bright, the top of the class, but deep down inside she was depressed. Or deep down inside, he didn't want to live anymore. We all knew that kid growing up. And you have to wonder, you know, for all your academic excellence, for all your, you know, athletic prowess, how come you're depressed? How come you feel like you're not enough? It's because I think as parents, sometimes we neglect what the child feels inside.
Yeah. That's why, ang magandang tip nito, talk to your kids, diba? Para alam mo din yung nasa loob niya. And, yun, ask mo din siya na gusto niya sa life niya, ganun. And, kailangan may full support tayo. Kailangan ina-explain natin. And minsan, ito minsan, ano, deceiving din sa mga anak, CJ. Minsan kasi, hindi rin sila CJ nagsasabi eh, ng napifeel nila. Like for example, may nag-bully sa kanila. Hindi nila yung kinakwento, di ba? May mga ganun, lalo na kapag mga high school na yung stage. Minsan hindi sila nagsasabi kung ano yung nangyayari sa school. And then sa bahay, magpe-pretend sila na, hi mom, hi ganito. And ikaw, pagka dumaan lang sila, ma-ignore mo lang, hi, ganyan. Hindi, dapat kamustahin mo rin siguro, di ba? Natin, kamustahin natin yung mga anak natin from kapag galing sila sa school na, oh, how school, ganyan. And, so in short, talk to them!
And diba? Also, avoid making your children feel as if their value relies directly with their excellence.
Ito, natutunan ko siya. Natutunan ko lang din to, ha? Hindi ako yung best example. Natutunan ko lang to recently. Na when you say, like, for example, Hila, you're very good. Kahit minsan wala rin naman ginawa si Kira, Kira, you're so good! Ganun din. Yun yung natutunan ko. And always praise your children. Anyway, number five. Baba na. Number five. Surrender control to God and be thankful.
It's pretty basic. When you say surrendering control, pretty much literally, you just give up all your complaints to Him. You leave it to God to address the matter for you. You let Him fight your battles for you. You let Him go ahead of you because you can. Be thankful that you're not in control. You know, if I...
Oh no.
Honestly speaking, I'm glad that I'm not in control.
Kalat na yung future.
Dahil, if I was the one solely in control of my children's welfare and their future, it wouldn't end up good for them. Even now that I'm a Christian, you know, I'm not God. I can't. And as parents, we are not God. We do not dictate to them what their future will be. We do not thrust upon them whatever dreams we may have of our own and force it upon them to live out those dreams for us. We have to let our children shine on their own accord. And you know, I'm thankful for that because then I know that God is in control of their future and not my own selfishness. Because they are not our property.
So number six, ask for the wisdom of parenting. No parent is perfect. Of course, we're not perfect parents. Each child is unique and only God can give you the wisdom to teach them. So ito yung isa din to sa napakaganda and dapat alam na alam natin. Kasi yun, minsan, hindi na natin maintindihan eh. Minsan out of control na tayo. Minsan we tried our best. Pero bakit ganun? Di ba, Siege? Sometimes may mga ganun na parents, no? Even us. Na, I tried my best. Parang feeling ko wala naman akong ginawa. bakit nagkaganon. Pero yun.
It's number 6, right?
Number 6. Yun, ang kailangan natin itanong, hindi lang yung sarili natin or our partners or our friends, but we have to ask wisdom kay God. And hindi lang pag may problema na or may question ka na, mag-ask ka din ng wisdom kung paano ka gustong gamitin ni Lord sa calling mo na maging mom or dad ka.
We need to ask Him for wisdom in all aspects of our lives. Because without that wisdom, we are all bound for destruction. So, especially if there's one area in my life where I want to seek God's wisdom, it's parenting. Because it is not solely our lives at stake here. You know?
Next generation!
It's the future generation. We can never protect them forever. We can never be them for their college days, for the days na they have to be on their own already. They will depart from your home and they will have their own values and foundations. So why not introduce them to the ultimate foundation, which is Christ.
Okay. Number 7. Family is more than just blood. Better if Christ blood. Okay, bagay din dito yung mga nag-adopt ng child or yung mga walang choice na punta sa kanila yung ano, na punta sa kanila yung bata. Not just about blood.
Not just about blood. What do you mean by that? You know, family is more than just blood. You don't have to be the real biological son or daughter of somebody for you to be loved and to feel loved. You know, it's love is, and family is more than that. It's the feeling of being at home with the people around you. It's the feeling of security with them.
Okay, so ako yung nag-top out. Kasi yung sobrang dati, ako yung pinaka-malabnaw. What really? Check yung consistency niya. Anyway, last words about, you wanna share about parenting? Ako muna.
Those are remarks ba to?
Anyway, ako muna. Siguro yung pinaka-gusto kong i-share, again, God first before your children or how you parent your children. My opinion, if no God in the picture, baka mas mahirap. Okay? And yun, and if you have a relationship na with God, mas nice pa rin if you ask for wisdom, if you always pray to God and pray with your children, pray for them, you're not in control. I-surrender mo yung way mo kay Lord.
I can't emphasize the fact enough that you always have to remember that your children are not your possessions, they're not your property.
That's Papa's drink.
They are borrowed blessings from God.
And of course, CJ, you can also ask your friends.
It's about surrounding your family also with the people who, I wouldn't say strictly close to God, but who share the same values as you, who share the same principles as your family, because at the end of the day, you know, birds of the same feather will flock together, and yep. You know, it's better to just be in that kind of environment and be in that situation where it would be optimal to raise your children.
But again, there's no perfect parents, love ya. Perfect parents.
And at the end of the day, also, there's no such thing as perfect parents.
Yeah, yeah.
You can keep trying, but you will never be a perfect parent. You can have all the money, you can have all the time, you can be the most hardworking. You can never be perfect in all aspects of parenting.
Saludo pa rin ako sa mga moms. Sa pag-give birth pa lang, saludo ako dyan. And also sa mga dads, saludo din dyan.
Dads.
Parents, mom, dad, saludo kami sa inyong lahat.
At hindi lang yung mga complete family. Let's also honor those
yes.
who are broken.
Yes.
You know, because
God, single parents.
Yung mga single
wow.
parents, mga
congrats.
Single mom, single
congrats.
Dads.
Galing.
Hindi madali ginagawa nyo.
Yes.
And you know, I cannot imagine my life without my wife to help me with my children.
Hey, hindi lang to sa mga parents, CJ, ha? Kahit sa mga nagpa-plan pa lang mag-conceive, kailangan meron na kayong foundation about parenting. So anyway, hey, check na natin. Tapos na tayo kanina pa natin. Ako lang yung nag-top up. Watery yung
ha-ha!
But let's see. May presentation pa tayo. mabawi ako sa presentation. Okay, Mavi, let's put na.
Decoration!
So blue, mere piercing through. I can't forget the day we met. Your smile so bright, it made me swoon. Our love is like a summer's day, hot and endless in a magic way. Whenever I see you, all I can think is my summer love. Been waiting for you, my love. My summer love. Been waiting for you, my love. I can't
so.
So that's a wrap. Remember to keep the faith and bye!
Bye!